Be ethical. Understanding car theft dynamics. The recent announcement by the Canadian government to ban Flipper Zero is part of a broader strategy aimed at curtailing the theft of vehicles equipped with keyless entry systems. To comprehend whether Flipper Zero can indeed facilitate the theft of such vehicles, it's pivotal to grasp the workings of keyless entry systems and the methodologies employed by car thieves to circumvent these systems. Unpacking keyless entry systems. Vehicles featuring keyless entry systems are engineered to unlock when the key fob is within a certain proximity, eliminating the need for the owner to physically press any buttons on the fob. Merely touching the vehicle's door handle activates the car's sensors, unlocking the doors. The methodology behind keyless entry system. To hijack a vehicle equipped with a keyless entry system, perpetrators typically operate in pairs, employing radio repeaters to deceive the vehicle into believing the key fob is closer than it actually is, often within the confines of the victim's home. This involves positioning one repeater in the vicinity of the vehicle and another near the household to bridge the connection with the key fob inside. The repeater close to the home is equipped with a sizable antenna capable of capturing signals through walls, given that key fobs are commonly placed near entryways. This setup tricks the car and key fob into thinking they're proximate, enabling the thieves to unlock the vehicle and initiate the ignition. The interaction between the key fob and the vehicle is reciprocal, with some keyless repeaters capable of extending the attack range up to 1 kilometer by relaying signals in both directions, while others limited by the key fob signal range only relay signals from the vehicle to the key fob. The requisites for transmitting signals through obstructions involve the use of extensive antennas and potent repeaters. Documented incidents of car theft demonstrate that the equipment used occupies substantial space in the perpetrator's backpacks. Decoding the equipment used in car theft. Specialized websites offer a plethora of car theft tools for various car brands, with keyless repeater searches yielding numerous online stores selling these tools globally, with prices ranging between 5K and 15 grand. The proliferation of social media videos where individuals claim to hack the Pentagon using Flipper Zero for increased viewership has fueled numerous myths, occasionally leading to legislative proposals based on misinformation. My aim in this video is to dispel some myths about Flipper Zero by addressing the following inquiries. Is car theft feasible with Flipper Zero? To date, there are no verified incidents of car theft using Flipper Zero, largely due to its limited functionality, which prevents it from being used as a repeater in keyless entry system attacks. Flipper Zero comprises a single sub 1 GHz radio module, in contrast to keyless repeaters, which feature 4 modules for comprehensive communication capabilities. While Flipper Zero can indeed intercept and decode radio signals, merely capturing a signal from a remote control is insufficient to unlock modern vehicles, which safeguard access through encrypted signals. The prevalent encryption technique in car keys is the rolling code, wherein each key fob button press generates a unique encrypted signal, thwarting simple attacks relying on basic radio modules. Understanding static versus rolling codes. Static codes transmit a consistent number sequence every time a remote button is pressed, allowing signal capture and replay for access. Conversely, rolling codes emit a unique code sequence with each button press, making signal capture and replay ineffective for unauthorized access. Although vehicles employing static codes have been phased out over the past 2 decades, their vulnerability lies in the ease with which their radio signals can be intercepted and replayed without sophisticated equipment. Static codes are remarkably vulnerable to the extent that they can be breached using just a wire connected to a computer's microphone input. I've provided a demonstration on how easy it is to capture a signal from a radio remote with a simple wire at the end of this video. This demonstrates the ineffectiveness of banning devices like Flipper Zero as a means to bolster security against signal interception. Think about it. Guarding against the capture of radio signals would require prohibiting almost all electronic devices, an approach that is completely impractical. Flipper Zero incorporates hardware components ubiquitous across numerous devices, from toys to DIY kits, exemplified by the widespread use of the CC1101 radio transceiver since 2007. The issue lies not in the accessibility of radio hardware, but in the inherent vulnerabilities of outdated access control systems. The fallacy of security through obscurity. The premise of keeping a system's design secret as a deterrent to exploitation is flawed, as eventual disclosure of the system's inner workings inevitably exposes vulnerabilities, rendering it susceptible to attacks. Addressing insecurity through effective measures, not bans. Rather than resorting to prohibitions, the focus should be on rectifying the inherent vulnerabilities within security systems. The cybersecurity realm has long acknowledged that bans are ineffective solutions that merely give the illusion of action rather than addressing the root causes of security flaws. Let's have a closer look at some real-world illustrations. Comparing HTTP and HTTPS. The evolution from HTTP to HTTPS on the World Wide Web serves as a prime example of adapting to secure communication protocols. Similarly, the banking industry's shift from magnetic strip cards to chip-enabled cards underscores a proactive approach to enhancing security. These examples underscore the necessity of adopting advanced security measures rather than imposing bans on tools that could potentially expose or exploit vulnerabilities. In the context of car thefts and the use of devices like Flipper Zero, the focus should be on improving vehicle security systems to counteract advanced theft techniques, rather than banning the tools that could, in the right hands, help identify and patch these vulnerabilities. By embracing innovation and enhancing security protocols, it's possible to stay ahead of threats rather than simply trying to hide or ban the means by which they are exposed. Want to know more? Check out this demonstration on how easy it is to capture a signal from a radio remote with a simple wire. Or check out one of my other cybersecurity related videos. And always remember to
be good.
Not every geek with a Commodore 64 can hack into NASA.